Were you there? Did you see him come in to Jerusalem? Did you see the big party that was going on? All the people. It was exciting. They're throwing cloaks down. They threw palm leaves down. He came riding in on a colt. It was exciting. They say he's the Messiah. He's here to save us. He's here to make a difference. Things are going to be like they were. We are going to be in charge again. He's our King. He can make it happen. Did you see that? Did you? It was awesome. This man from Galilee, he came riding in triumphantly. I was excited. Weren't you? Weren't you? All those people. This man from Galilee came riding in, and he is here for us. I hear he is here to celebrate Passover with us. He brought his 12 friends. They're going to celebrate a Passover meal here with all of us here in Jerusalem. That is so cool. And I heard that as he was starting to celebrate, some different things started to happen. What was it you said? What? Well, I don't know if I can share. No. It wouldn't be right to. No. It's trusted sources, though. Maybe I should share. There's nothing wrong if I do that, right? I can tell you what's going on, right? I heard he's eating right now with his disciples. He's eating with them. I mean, before he ate with them, you know what he did? He took off his cloak and he washed their feet. This rabbi was washing his friend's feet. Yeah. And why him? Shouldn't they be doing that? He's the Messiah. He's washing their feet. Sure is kind of different. Sure is different what he's doing. I don't get it. I've never heard of such a thing. Seems a bit outrageous to me. But that's what I was told happened. I was told that it happened. But then, something else happened too. That's what I was told also. I don't know, I'm not sure I should share it though. Might be too much. Nah. Should I?
Yes.
Should I tell them? Is it okay? Is it okay I share that news? They're in a Passover meal. He took the bread after he had blessed it. And he said, take and eat. This is my body. Now what the heck is going on here? He's saying, this is my body? And then he took the cup. And after giving thanks, he said, take and drink this all day. This is a new covenant shed in my blood. That's his blood. I heard he wasn't bleeding, but he said, this is a covenant shed in my blood. For what is he saying? Can you imagine what he's going to tell you now? For forgiveness of your sins and my sins and everyone's sins. Seems a bit far-fetched. But if he's the Messiah, if he's the one that God sent for us, oh, I got chills now. Just thinking about that. It is a bit odd.
No.
No. That isn't true, is it? So in the heat, he bread and wine to him. Has just left the room because he's going out to betray Jesus. He's going to betray the Messiah? He's going to betray the Messiah who came into town riding on that colt in glory? Can't be true. We can't. He's our Messiah. Who would do that? Who would do that? Are you spreading rumors about that? Or is that truth? Gotta be careful. I just can't imagine that would happen. And one of his friends. One of his friends is about to stab him in the back. I can't imagine anybody would stab their friend in the back like that, let alone the Messiah. I hear these guys have been walking around for 3 years. They've been with him for 3 years. And one of them will betray them? People don't betray their friends. Do they? They betrayed the one that God sent for us? The one that's going to make everything right again? No. Can't be. It just... can't be.
Christmas tonight service is from the Old Testament. In seminary, they taught us that now is the Hebrew Bible. And it's going to be on your Pew Bibles, page 54. And the first reading is from Exodus 12, 1 through 14. Israel remembered its deliverance from slavery in Egypt by celebrating the festival of Passover. His festival featured the Passover lamb, whose blood was used as a sign to protect God's people from the threat of death. The early church described the Lord's Supper using imagery from the Passover, especially in portraying Jesus as the lamb who delivers God's people from sin and death. Verse 1. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron, in the land of Egypt, this month shall mark for you the beginnings of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the whole congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month, they are to take a lamb for each family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in obtaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportions to the number of people who eat of it. Your lamb shall be without blemish. A year old male, you might take it from the sheep or from the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. Then the whole assembled congregation of Israel shall slaughter it at twilight. They shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and the lintel of the house in which they eat it. They shall eat the lamb the same night. They shall eat it roasted over the fire with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. Do not eat any of it raw or boiled in water, but roast it over the fire, which is hands, legs, and inner organs. You shall let none of it remain until the morning. Anything that remains until the morning you shall burn. This is how you shall eat it: your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand. And you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord, for I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. And all the gods of Egypt I will execute judgment. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you in the house where you live. When I see the blood, I will pass over you. And no plague shall destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This day shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord. Throughout your generations shall observe it as perpetual ordinance. Second reading is from the Epistle of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11, 23 to 26. In the bread and the cup of the Lord's Supper, we experience intimate fellowship with Christ and one another, because it involved his body given for us and the new covenant in his blood. Faithful participation in this meal is a living proclamation of Christ's death until he comes in the future. Verse 23. For I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup of me. Also, after supper, saying, "This is the cup, is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes."
You may rise if you like for the gospel. It is a long reading, so I am pre-warning you. The Holy Gospel of John, the 13th chapter, can be found today in your Pew Bible on page 94 in the New Testament. Page 94 in the New Testament. The story of the Last Supper in John's Gospel recalls a remarkable event not mentioned elsewhere. Jesus performed a duty of a slave, washing the feet of his disciples and urging them to do the same for one another. The Holy Gospel, according to John, the 13th chapter, starting at verse 1. Now, before the festival of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it into the heart of Judas, son of Simon of Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given him all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, tied a towel around himself, and then he poured water into the basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "The one who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was going to betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet and put on his robe and returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set an example that you should also do as I have done to you. Very truly, I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them. Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am only with you a little longer. You will look for me. And as I have said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another, just as I have loved you. You also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." The Gospel of our Lord.